My man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday. And don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 10 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. Also, a great newsletter, The Opening Call. Now, it's very easy to get The Opening Call, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN, and you're going to see right into featured content, The Opening Call by our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. Now, Basil just did a subscriber webinar, folks, okay? That webinar is on his page. As you sign up, the bottom line, what will end up happening is that you're going to not only get a great newsletter for a month, you're going to get the archives that Basil already has on there. The newsletter, the cost of the newsletter is $149 for 1 month, $6.95 for six, which is a savings of $199, and it's $11.95 for the year, which is a savings of $593. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So as you get the newsletter, you're going to get a great newsletter, you're going to get some great archives, and we're going to understand, bottom line, how to ride that Chapman wave each and every day. Basil Chapman, what's going on? You did double duty today, too, man. Thank you.
I did. My pleasure.
Yeah, and, totally.
Yeah, it's a little difficult because Tommy does a terrific job of putting the fundamentals together with the technicals. So
you did a great job. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Fabulous. Absolutely fabulous.
So, here we are at all-time highs.
Another day, another high.
How many times have we said that this year? Well, this is very interesting. So just real briefly, I just want to, for new people who come to my work, I try to identify the lowest low bar, and then if the technicals concur, as soon as it rallies, I ascribe to each higher peak a letter. It's uppercase on the way up. And the letters can go A, B, C, D, E, F, G to seven higher peaks. But it's at the fourth highest peak, P, D, that other things can happen. Could go a little higher to E. But at the same time, this is where I become a little bit cautious. We've done that in my newsletter for I don't know how many years. Often I've spoken to you over the period of a year. And I say, okay, now we're getting to a D or an E. And I say, this is where we become rather cautious. So I'm going to put in a little circle. I don't want to make it too complicated because in my show tomorrow, I'm going to be going through everything. That's during my Tiger Technician's Hour at 10 a.m. But in the Chapman Wave methodology, what I'm looking for is that once we get to a peak D, that's where I do an assessment and I say, okay, where are we? We've been long the Dow. We were along the core position going back to March of last year, but we also have trading positions. And the last one we got in long, somewhere around 35,000 about 2.5 weeks ago. And we've lightened up a little bit. And this is where we start to implement some kind of insurance. So now we've got a little insurance and we are still long a position. We actually have started a short position and we're in leg E. But what I have to mention right now is that normally whenever we get to a millennial level, in other words, a millennium level, 1,000 points, that's where I become a little cautious. And very often, just before you get there, you start hitting resistance. And that was at 35,900. But we've gone right through it for the second day now. We've gone to 36,000. Above 36,000. We're at 36,053. My contention is that if we start to trade on a closing basis at about 36,132, then instead of being a repellent zone, it's like a magnet zone, the 36,000. So I'm trying to make it as simple as possible. Only the on-balance volume in my work, other than the letter E, and the on-balance volume are suggesting that there could be some kind of a pullback, and I believe that we've got to be ready for that. And so we're preparing. And if you look at the S&P, what are we looking at? We're looking at a leg D. Well, there it is. There's your leg D with an all-time high at 46,35. So nothing really to see other than here again. It's the letter, the notation D, and it's the on-balance volume, this little blue line, which is overextended. But what's really interesting is that the QQQ, the NDX 100 trading vehicle, this is the Invesco Trust Series, Qs at 388.72 at an all-time high, but it's only in leg C. So when we get this rotational aspect, what happens often is that in the at lows, you get a coincident low, but at tops, you can rotate through at different times. So I'm looking at this, and I think that IWM Russell 2000 is made an alternate count leg F. I'm looking at this and saying, this is about where I would anticipate some kind of a pullback. It doesn't mean it has to happen. It doesn't even mean that it has to be deep. But this is where I've become a little cautious. We've done it enough times that I feel comfortable saying, you know, a bit of caution. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. We have now just two short positions in our entire portfolio. We've got some positions that are at either yearly or all-time highs. So I want to be careful. So basically I'm saying right at this particular moment, not looking out to the rest of the year, but just in this particular time frame, a little bit of caution I think is appropriate. I do say that when the Dow makes... when it survives September and October and it's able to close the last day of November or last day of October, the first week of November, almost at all time, at either all-time highs or the yearly high, then even if there's a pullback, usually you get by in December, you get your close the last day of December, somewhere near those highs. So that's kind of my belief right now, but I wouldn't be surprised if we are pretty close to some kind of a pullback. So that's kind of what I'm looking at this moment.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting tomorrow, man. I mean, you know, like I said, at the beginning of the show, we seem to always think that the Fed day is going to be big. But this one, I mean, I think this one is going to be big.
well, they've announced that it's important. So we have to respect that. And we don't know what they're going to say, but you have to respect the fact that, if you go to the TLT, I've made the parameters quite clear in my show. I've said if there is a close in the TLT at this point, it's at 147. If there's a close at any point in the next week above 149.70 or 150.30, around about that area, if you get even into that area, that essentially says, okay, rates are going to be pulling back and they could be pulling back for a little bit longer. But I can just tell you, if there is a sudden slide and you're looking at the TLT, which is the 20-year Lehman Treasury Bond Fund, and it closes somewhere below 144 or 143, that's going to be a problem. I think the Fed's going to have no choice, but they're going to be watching yields go up and they're going to be kind of stuck. So,
well, you know, it's going to be interesting. Yes. So picture this, folks, okay? You got Powell's coming up for your nomination, right?
Oh, that's
you
the
got,
other thing.
You got that no one wants rates to go up, right? Meaning politics. I'd say it, no one wants rates to go up anyway. It doesn't matter who you are, right? So that's going to be some pressure also, right? I mean, you know, it's really like, okay, so this, more than likely, folks, this is almost one of the last meetings. In fact, if I look at December, I don't know if there's a December meet. Here, let me do this quick. 1 second. Because they Fed, F-E-D.
It should be.
Yeah, there's a couple times that there aren't meetings. In a month. Let's see. So meetings, there's meetings. Okay, so let's see.
So there's a political angle to this as well.
There is, man. I mean, you know, they say that, yeah, it's non-political, but guess what? We know how this goes. Everyone wants their job.
Absolutely.
Calendar. Come on.
So it's an interesting time, at least in the short term, and then we'll see how things settle down.
No doubt. It's real easy to get Basil's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right on the front page, featured content. Hit that button. Basil, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you, Tom. You too.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.